वेलकम बैक टू माय इंग्लिश लर्निंग यूट्यूब चैनल। माय डियर व्यूअर्स एंड सब्सक्राइबर्स, आई एम डिस्कसिंग वॉइस सेंस इन माय वीडियोस। आई हैव ऑलरेडी अपलोडेड सम वीडियोस रिगार्डिंग द चैप्टर वॉइस एक्टिव एंड पैसिव। सो हियर आई एम राइटिंग द नेम ऑफ द टॉपिक वॉइस, यू कैन सी ऑन द बोर्ड। एंड एवरीबॉडी नोज दैट वॉइस इज ऑफ टू काइंड्स and this has already been discussed. Today I will discuss the voices of past perfect continuous tense. Okay, here I am writing the name of the tense, past perfect continuous tense. Here, past perfect continuous tense. But remember it, you must remember this thing, that the voices of past perfect continuous tense is rarely seen in use. That means in most of the grammars you can see that the voice tense of past perfect continuous tense is not used. It is very rarely used. Yet we have to learn. That is why I am writing here the active voice of past perfect continuous tense. Now it will be subject, then had, then been, then main verb with ing. Okay. Then there will be object, and there must be an object, because in passive voice we have to make this object a subject. Okay, otherwise no voice sense is possible without an object in the sentence. Okay, then if there is something else, then we have to write it as an extension. Now, in order to make you better understanding, I am giving here number 1 and here number 2, because the place or position of the subject and object will be exchanged in passive voice. Okay, I am writing an example here. Here you can see we had been learning English for an hour. So this is a sentence of past perfect continuous tense. Here it is the sentence of active voice. Now we have to change it into passive voice. That is why I am writing here the structure of passive form of past perfect continuous tense. I hope you are getting the point. Okay. Now that object will be the subject here. That is why I have put here number 2. Again, had will remain as the same. That means had must be written as had, then been must come, then as we know, then when there is ing with a verb, we must write being in passive form. Okay, so you are already getting the point. Here I have written subject, then had, been is present, I have written here been, and we have to write an access word, that is being. And why we have to write this access word? Because there is ing with the main verb. So when there is ing with the main verb, then we must write being. And this is one of the greatest characteristics of passive form, with the verb with ing. Okay. Then we have to use the past participle form of the main verb. In any sentence of passive voice, we have to use the past participle form of the main verb. Then we have to write by. And finally, this subject will become here an object. Okay. So this will be an object, but this object is not written here. That subject has become here object. That is why I am writing here 1 for better identification. Okay, that means this 1 has gone there. Okay, now if there is an extension, we have to write it. So this is a sentence of past perfect continuous tense and already in active voice. Now we'll change this sentence into passive one. For that, we have to choose or find out the object. Now, what is the object here? And I have already told you that how to find out an object, we have to ask question to the verb by using the question word what or whom. That means we have been learning English. What have we been learning English? The answer is definitely English. Have we been learning? The answer is definitely English. So this is the object here. And this object will come here to be a subject, so English. here English, I have written English, then head will come, again beam will come, then as there is ing, beam will come, okay. So English had been being learned, we have to use the past participle form of the main verb. English had been being learned, then we have to write by, and this subject will be the object here, it will be us, object of we is us, and this is the, and here is an extension for an hour. So English had been being learned by us for an hour. So this is a sentence of, this is a sentence of past perfect continuous tense which has been changed into passive one. That is why I have written here P and here it is an. Okay, so this is the structure of past perfect continuous tense, and we have to learn this sentence or the passive form. This is very rarely used in English grammar, yet we have to learn because we are learning, as we are learning the passive form, passive voice, so we have to learn every tense. Okay, but you may get this, though it is rarely used, yet sometimes some question of this passive voice may be asked in any interview or profession or for entering into a job. Okay, that is why you have to know the structure. So I will not write more examples here, I will write only one example of these tenses, then I will discuss again the other tenses which we have already learned in our previous videos, because we have already learned the passive voice of eight number of tenses. Okay, eight number of tenses, when present, four tenses of present tense and another four of past tense. Okay, now I am writing one more example of past perfect continuous tense to change it into passive one. So you can see here, the boy had been drawing a nice picture. So this is a sentence of past perfect continuous tense, and it is an inactive voice, and it must be changed into passive. And here the object is a nice picture is the object here. So a nice picture had been, then being, had been being drawn, it will be drawn. Okay, a nice picture had been being drawn by the boy. Okay, so this is the sentence of passive voice. Here I will write some more sentences for our practice, and that will be also a revision. We will be a revision what we have already or previously learned. Okay, so you can see the boy had been drawing a nice picture. A nice picture had been being drawn by the boy. Now I write some more sentences of other tenses. Okay, so you see, you have washed the car just now. You have washed the car just now. So this is the sentence of active voice. Now I'll write, the boy is, the boy is expecting a good news. Again, again I am writing, we did the work. We did the work yesterday. We did the work yesterday. Again, I am writing number 5. The poor are helped by the girl. So here I have written 5 sentences of 5 different tenses, where the number 1 is you have washed the car just now. So this is a sentence of active voice and it is in the perfect tense, that means it is in present perfect tense. Here the object is the car and it must be the subject here, the car. And as there is have, then we have to use have verb only. And with the car, it is the third person singular number, that is why has will come. And as there is has, been must come. So the car has been, then we have to use the past participle form of the main verb. Here the washed is already past participle form. The car has been washed by you just now. Okay, this is a sentence of passive voice, where it was a sentence of active voice. Again, number 2, the boy is expecting a good news. So here, what the boy is expecting? A good news. This is the object here. And we have to make or use it as a subject. So here I am writing a good news. Then a good news, though you see that there is as with news, it is not a plural word, because news itself is a singular word. Okay, that is why we have to use the be verb is here. A good news is, and as there is ing with the verb, we have to use being. Okay, a good news is being, then it will be the past participle form of expect, which is expected. A good news is being expected by the boy. Okay, I hope you are getting the point. Okay, very easy to understand if you pay a little attention and you fuse watch the videos very closely. Okay, now number 3, accidents are caused by carelessness. So definitely this is a sentence of passive voice, where we can see are and we can see by. And as we see are here and after are, we can see the past participle form of the verb. Definitely it is the sentence of present indefinite tense, and the structure of present indefinite tense must be subject, verb, object. So which part will be the subject here? Definitely the part which is written after by, that part was the subject in that active voice. That is why we have to omit by, and as we have to write in this structure, we have also to omit are here. Now carelessness will become the subject. Okay, you can see carelessness. Then the verb must be in present tense, it will be cause. But you can see carelessness is the third person singular number verb subject. That is why the verb cause will take as with you. So it will be carelessness causes accidents. The subject must become here an object. So carelessness causes accidents. Okay. So very good sentence and meaningful sentence which we have to remember. Always remember. Okay, this is a sentence of passive voice, while this one is a sentence of active voice. Now number 4, we did the work yesterday. As we see that here is the verb did, and it is the past tense form of do. So this is a sentence of past indefinite tense. So we have to change it into passive, okay, according to the rule of past indefinite tense. So the verb will become the subject here. And as there is did, that means the verb is in past tense, with work was has to be written. The work was do did done. We have to use the past participle form of do, that is done. The work was done by us yesterday. Okay, the work was done by us yesterday. This one is the passive voice. The last, the poor are helped by the girl. Here also, you may not see this sentence if I write at the bottom of the board or at the very below of this sentence. So I am erasing this number one sentence and I will write this sentence at the top. So you can see are is placed here, by is written here. Inactive, we have to drop or omit these two words, by and are. And after by, the girl will be the subject in the active voice sentence. So five implies I am writing the girl. Okay, the girl. Then we have to drop are, and the verb must be in its present tense form. So it will be help. It will be help. The girl help. Again, we have to see the subject. The subject here is the girl, and the tense is present indefinite tense. So it is the third person singular number subject. That is why we have to add as with help. Okay, that is why it will become the girl helps the poor. Okay, the poor. So this is the sentence of active voice, and you can see that one by one I have uploaded many videos regarding the voice sense, regarding voice sense. Okay, and in most cases I am revising all the rules and structures of voice sense. Already we have learned eight kinds of tenses, the voice sense of eight kinds of tenses, and in every tense we are revising. Okay, we are revising every tense if when I get the opportunity, and it is done only because of your convenience. Okay, so please keep watching my videos, and if you have some valuable suggestion, please let me know by your comment, and I will be inspired by getting your comments and subscription and views. So I always thank you from the core of my heart for watching my videos. Thank you for today.